say amen.
Amen.
Come on, say amen again.
Amen.
This time say it like you know God is real.
Amen.
You all do know that Christ is coming again. Now, there are two dates circled on the Jewish calendar. That's when the Christ comes the first time, and when he comes the second time. The first time Christ came, he came to save the church. But the next time he comes, he's coming to rapture his church. This is what Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 51. He says, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep. But watch this, we shall be changed. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. See, the reason why we got to be changed is because when you die, when those who have died, they have already been changed. But if we're going to get to heaven and we come back, we're still alive when Christ comes back, we can't go to heaven the same way. That's why we got to be
changed.
You can't go to heaven with a bad attitude. You got to be
changed.
You can't go to heaven smoking weed and drinking. You got to be
changed.
You can't go to heaven lying and cheating and stealing. You got to be
changed.
We shall be
changed.
In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, we'll be changed. Worshiping God in this way. Perhaps you can experience or have experienced what Abraham had experienced. Not so much that God has asked you for some type of human sacrifice where you're going to kill your wife, your spouse, your child, your friend. No, but you came to church and your heart was heavy. You came to church and God was the last thing on your mind. You came to church and you were worried about this job that you're on where they're laying off. You came to church and you were thinking about how much bills you had and how little money you had. You came to church and you were thinking about what's going on in your marriage. All you know is that, you know, things ain't what they used to be. You can't put your finger on it, but you know that home ain't right. You came to church and home, your children, they're acting out. They're all of a sudden getting in trouble at school. All of a sudden, their grades are dropping. They won't talk to you. And truth be told, you don't feel like singing songs aloud. Truth be told, you don't feel like getting on your knees and praying. If the truth be told, like you really didn't feel like reading the Bible. If the truth be told, you don't feel like standing, shouting, jumping. You don't feel like even being here, if truth be told. Anybody can praise God when things are going your way. Anybody can praise God when the sun is in your face, the wind is in your back, and your hands have money inside of it. Anybody can praise God when a doctor has written you a clean bill of health. Anybody can praise God as long as you're happy, you got joy. But can you praise God when things ain't going your way? Abraham has to praise God in a different way. God has never asked Abraham to praise him like this before. God has never asked anybody to praise him like this before. And so Abraham has to praise God in a new way. See, some of y'all are caught up in this routine worship. You can't worship God outside of your box. You only stand up when your song come on. You only stand up at the end of the message. Why can't you stand up right now?
Now, if you don't mind, would you stand on the night? Grab your neighbor by the hand. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your love and your mercy, your grace. Lord, we thank you for life, health, and strength. Lord, we thank you. And everything we have has come from you. So, Lord, bless your preacher tonight. Bless your people. And then, Lord, on tonight, we stand interceding for the Oklahoma City Thunder. Lord, give them victory tonight to close out game four. And then, Lord, we ask you to give them power to defeat Memphis or San Antonio. We don't care. We just ask that Kevin Durant be at his best. Then, Lord, we also pray on tonight. We also pray on tonight that you give us preacher power. In Jesus' name, let every heart say amen.
Amen.
Can I grab your Bibles?